Thank you. Thank you. what Curtis is starting to do.
I can just start playing on two as well as the rest of the game.
Okay.
Is it the bomb?
Okay.
Do you don't.
So the second time we do it that way, the third time we do it that way. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
Thank you. Please be seated. Thank you. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Dalhousie University's Spring Convocation for the Faculty of Engineering. My name is Frank Harvey. I am the Provost and Vice President Academic. It is such a distinct honor and privilege to be serving in that role, and I will be the MC for today's ceremony. We are all absolutely thrilled that we can be here in person to celebrate this great day. I'd like to ask Elder Catherine Martin, our Director of Indigenous Community Engagement, to deliver the traditional Mi'kmaq welcome.
Kwe, Delasi, Medawaloktiok, and Willyexit Bu. Anin Gadalan Maltai. And I'd like to welcome all of you to the unceded territory of my ancestors, my relatives, my family, the Mi'kmaq or the Ulnu of this land. I'd take a lot of pride in reminding us all of the Treaty of the 1752 and a few amendments here and there, but basically the Peace and Friendship Treaty signed by the newcomers, the British and the Mi'kmaq, to allow and ensure that we as Mi'kmaq would live according to our way of life that we had lived for thousands of years for, and that we would ensure, it would ensure that we would continue to live as peace and friendship people with the new peoples who have come that we share our land with. Congratulations to all of the graduates today and to all of the parents and family members who have gone on this journey with all of them. So I'd like to thank all of you again for coming today and to welcome you with open arms to our territory. However, before I leave this lovely stage, first of all, I want to say, yesterday at the end of the second one yesterday, I met this wonderful mom and her son and sister from Uganda. And they flew all the way here, just in time, except the dad missed the flight in Toronto and Montreal, so he didn't get here. But I was already emotional to be here for all these ones, but then to see how, you know, people would come from far away and do anything to honor their relative that's here is touches me. I also wanted to take a moment, because we are so privileged to be here, we also have to remember those who aren't, and especially those who are in deep, deep sorrow over the loss of children in this country, but especially in Texas, where the people of the parents and family members are having a very difficult time with the loss of such beautiful hopes for the future. So please take a moment of silence and send them good wishes. Walaliok emsit nogma.
Thank you very much, Kathy, for that beautiful welcome. It's been absolutely wonderful to have you here during all of our ceremonies to deliver your beautiful welcome. So thank you again for that. I would also like to begin by acknowledging that Dalhousie University and our community benefit from and sit on Mi'kma'ki, the ancestral and unceded territory of the Mi'kmaq people. We are very grateful for our partnerships and our friendships across our campuses and our faculties and our administrative units. We are very grateful for our community leaders, our elders and residents, our Indigenous Advisory Council, our Director of Indigenous Community Engagement, Indigenous Student Center, Indigenous Research Facilitator in the VP Research Office, Indigenous Health Program and Inclusive Pathways to the Medical and Health Professions, and many other critically important initiatives and partnerships across our campuses and our faculties and our administrative units, including the Faculty of Engineering. We will continue to work on and build on these critically important relationships and friendships because we are all treaty people and we take these words and our commitment to truth and reconciliation very seriously. We would also like to acknowledge the histories, the contributions, and the legacies of the African Nova Scotian people and communities who have been here for over 400 years. We are very grateful for our African Nova Scotian Advisory Council and our Director of African Nova Scotian Community Engagement. There are two times on a university campus that are particularly significant. The first, of course, is at the start of every term when we welcome our students into the university and on campus and into their new programs. And the second is at the end of the journey when we come together as we are today to celebrate the completion of your programs. Now, for many, this day comes with a range of emotions, sadness at leaving Dalhousie and your Dal community and your Dal friends, perhaps a little eagerness to move on from Dalhousie and Nova Scotia, possibly a little fear and anxiety about the future, and certainly gratitude, I am sure gratitude for all those who supported you along the way. But among the different emotions you and your classmates are working through right now, I hope you feel pride. You've accomplished something that very few can and only a few dream of, and you should be proud of the many significant and noteworthy achievements. Completing your degree, particularly in these unique circumstances of a global pandemic, certainly gives all of us reason to be incredibly proud of you and your accomplishments. Convocation marks the culmination of years of very, very hard work. You've spent hundreds of hours in classes, tutorials, and labs. You've written and studied hundreds of pages of notes extracted from those classes, tutorials, and labs. You've solved thousands of assignment problems. Many of you have had your first exposure to professional practice through co-op. You have continued to find the time to be student leaders in societies, athletics, design competitions, extracurricular activities. You have demonstrated the completeness of your learning and preparedness for industry through successful capstone projects. You've completed hundreds of quizzes and midterms and final exams, and you've all made many, many good friends along the way. But you've also spent a good part of the last several years balancing school and work and social lives. You've been dealing with fears and anxieties about your programs and your future. You've been taking chances and risks on program choices and courses. You've been dealing with relationships and social pressures, maybe a little pressure from your parents and family. You've been managing your budget, in many cases juggling one, perhaps even two or more jobs to cover tuition. And I'm sure you've dealt with personal and emotional crises and losses, perhaps losses tied to the pandemic. Your graduation today speaks volumes about your capacity and your willingness to succeed anywhere by applying the life lessons, the skills, the knowledge, the passions, and the life choices you've been collecting and living through over the last 4 to 5 years. Again, convocation marks the end of years of very, very hard work. So don't let anyone tell you after graduation that it's time to, quote, get in the game. You've been in the game for several years, including through a pandemic. These are the reasons that we're here today celebrating. These are the reasons your family, your friends, the entire Dalhousie community are so incredibly proud of you. You inspire us. So feel free to make some noise. Congratulations. Family and friends, although we would typically encourage you to walk around the auditorium and take as many pictures and photographs as you would like for health and safety reasons, we're going to ask you to please stay in your seat, stand up, and take as many pictures as you'd like. We have photographers from Life Touch who will be taking additional close-up photos, and you can access those. And please do share your best photos online through hashtag DalGrad. And as always, convocation will be webcast, so you can have the pleasure of watching it and sharing the celebration through our Dal website. What I'd like to do now is just take a moment to introduce those individuals who will be participating in our ceremony today, starting with Scott Bryson, Dalhousie's Chancellor, Dr. Deep Saini, Dr. Deep Saini, President and Vice Chancellor, Dr. Louise Spiteri, Interim Chair of Senate, Dr. John Newhook, the Dean of the Faculty of Engineering, Dr. Hani El Nagar, the Associate Dean, Faculty of Graduate Studies, Elder Catherine Martin, who delivered the traditional Mi'kmaq welcome a few moments ago, Quinta Adams, our Director of Student Academic Success, and the 2021 recipient of the Rosemary Gill Award for Outstanding Service to Students, who carried the New Dawn staff leading our graduates into the ceremony. Thank you, Quinta. And Dr. Barrett Kerlick, Assistant Professor in Engineering and our convocation speaker today. Also on the platform today and in the audience are many other faculty, staff, and administrators, including our associate deans, VPs, members of the Registrar's Office, and many others who are so critical to the success of our students and to the academic excellence, of our programs. Can you all stand, please? This is our opportunity to thank them. Thank you. Please be seated. I would now like to ask Dr. Deep Saini, our president, to deliver the president's remarks.
Thank you, Dr. Harvey, graduates, families, and friends, and distinguished guests. A very warm welcome to you all. What an honor and what an immense pleasure it is to finally have the opportunity to join you all in person for this convocation. After two very difficult years, which kept us apart physically, it is a very welcome return to this important rite of passage. Today's ceremony blends long traditions with appropriate adjustments, such as wearing of masks, for example, for the times that we're going through, and a nod to the place where Dalhousie is located, this beautiful part of Mi'kma'ki that we call Nova Scotia, our home. This ceremony is a celebration of your transition from students to graduates and alumni. But much, much more importantly, it is a celebration of your achievements. This milestone is a very well-earned personal recognition of your efforts and your abilities, and a source of great pride, certainly for you, but also for your supporters who are here and some who are not here. So, class of 2020, you know it only too well that it would be an understatement to say that the past couple of years did not quite play out as we had all imagined. I don't think any of us would have imagined what we have gone through for the past 2 years and roughly 3 months. But regardless of the incessant challenges that the circumstances threw at you since the beginning of 2020, here you are. Despite what you were given, look what you've done with it. You've met your goal, and you're here, receiving the testament to your perseverance, resilience, grit, and determination. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for this amazing class of graduates who have done all of that. Bravo. I know it wasn't the student experience you had imagined, but you overcame great obstacles to make it to this day. You traveled, some of you very far, along the way navigating evolving restrictions here in Canada and abroad. You adapted and collaborated and made the most of online learning, gaining new skills and insights, and in the process, helping first to create and then to refine a whole new paradigm for how the university education will be delivered and received. Many of the lessons we learned through these shared experiences of ours will, in fact, endure, offering new and better learning tools to the future generations. Someday, you will look back and proudly recall that this is where it all began, and you were all central to getting it done. Thank you very much. You have not had it easy, but I dare to imagine that someday you will also look back and realize, that is, if you don't already do so, that this experience has made you stronger. Perhaps it has made you more resilient, more creative, more innovative, more empathetic, more civic-minded, and more conscious of how actions of one impact many, and more committed to striving for a better tomorrow. And these are exactly the traits that our world needs today. Over the past 2 years, the phrase, the new normal, has become an increasingly familiar part of our lexicon. However, for a society to enter a new normal is really nothing unique in itself. If you look back at the history, you will realize that the human history is replete with many, many turning points of similar magnitude. So, what is unique about this experience that you have gone through and or we have all gone through together? Well, the uniqueness of this particular new normal resides in the confluence of the daunting and often wicked challenges that are coincident with it. You know what those challenges are, but just to keep us focused on what lies ahead and what we need to deal with, let me cite a few examples. Climate change and its looming impacts, which are not just coming, they are here today with us. The recognition of on an unprecedented scale around the world that they have been historical wrongs and they must be righted, and they must be righted urgently. New global public health challenges, the need to feed a projected population of at least 9 billion on this planet without destroying the planet. The challenges to democracy, peace, and global order that we are facing as we speak, and the senseless violence which we continue to see in our societies and which Cathy Martin alluded to with such emotion. We see that in our societies today. Now it's gotten a bit depressing, isn't it? Well, that's not my intention, although you might be wondering, who is this person? Who is this Grinch trying to spoil a perfectly good party? Well, that's not my intention, then let me get to the point I'm trying to make. The point is that the task in front of you will not be easy. That's a given. It will indeed demand a great deal of you, and that too is a given. But what is also given is that your generation has demonstrated again and again that you have what it takes to overcome extreme circumstances. You've just done it. When I see you and see what you have become and what you have overcome over the past years, and especially how you have overcome it, and I get back to saying what you have become as a result of all of that, I feel totally confident that the world is in very, very competent hands. And in this particular case, now that's true of all the young people who are graduating today, but in this particular case, on this day, those hands, those competent hands, belong to engineers. As engineers, you are at the forefront of innovation. You have been at the forefront of innovation for a very long time. You are builders, you are creators, you are problem solvers, and many more things. And many of you are going to go on to become managers and leaders and so on. So you have a very special and unique responsibility in dealing with the challenges that I speak about, and I feel that as graduates of Dalhousie University, you are totally equipped to do that. Don't forget that. So, with that, let's get back to the celebration. Today is a big day, very big day for you all, very, very big day for all of us. As you cross the stage today and become a member of the worldwide community of university graduates, you also join the Dalhousie alumni family, which is a distinguished group that has in fact already left an indelible mark on societies around the world. I have no doubt whatsoever that you will uphold this tradition, and the years to come will see you too achieving great things, both for yourselves, but more importantly, for the world. While you do so, I hope you will retain your fond memories of your time here at Dalhousie University and your roots at your alma mater. You, our graduates, are the greatest source of joy and pride for all of us. So on behalf of Dalhousie University, please accept my heartfelt congratulations and very best wishes for a brilliant future that I know you richly deserve. Thank you, congratulations to you all, and please stay in touch.
Thank you, President Saini. Will graduates please rise? Mr. Chancellor, as Chair of the Senate of Dalhousie University, I ask you to confer degrees on those candidates whose names have been approved by Senate.
By virtue of the authority vested in me and in Dalhousie University, I admit to their respective degrees and diplomas with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto those candidates who have fulfilled the requirements of that degree and whose names have been approved by the Senate. Admitto vos ad gradum.
Graduates, please be seated.
I'd now like to call upon Dr. John Newhook, the Dean of the Faculty of Engineering, Dr. Hani L. Nagar, Associate Dean, Faculty of Graduate Studies, and Wesley Giffen, an orator from the Fountain School of Performing Arts, to present the candidates who are here today receiving degrees.
Mr. Chancellor, as Dean, I'm both pleased and proud to be here today to celebrate the accomplishments of these incredible candidates who have fulfilled the requirements for diploma degrees in the Faculty of Engineering.
Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Diploma in Engineering. Connor Reginald Alders. Nizar Khalil Musa Al-Balushi. Anas Mohammed Saif Al-Majarbi. Caitlin Arab. Elizabeth Estatke. Kieran Trevor Black. Albert Badley. Matthew Chapa. Shivam Chahan. Vlad Christian Chirac. Emma Corin Crockett. Siddhan Dadas. Hayden Joseph Ehler. Kareem Mohammed Al-Bashibi. Dimitri James Antonio Celia. Denise Engin. Kelsey Lynn Hahn. Audrey Marie Riviera Hill. Mohammed Johar. Benjamin Jarian. Matthew Kenneth Keane. Carl Karam. Muhammad Dali Sadiq Khalif.
Nimi Landisman.
Nimi Landisman. Melanie Virginia Langmaid. Devin Michelle Leishman. Asia Xiao Fale. Peyton Emily Lipset. Benjamin Raymond McGilvery. Ryan Joseph Malley. Rochelle Morales. David Andrew McCurdy. Sapna Natarajan. Nicholas Kirby Palov. Evan Daniel Pierce. Alexandra Catherine Rose Pimentel. Shamir Kesser. Hadi Qureshi. Marina Rincon Guerra. Gabrielle John Roberts. Liam Jordan Salzman. Ken Sean Shakira. Tree Ann. Ioannis Triopoulos. Patrick Wayne. Ethan Alexander Young. Yuchen Zhang. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Diploma in Engineering. Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Bachelor of Engineering. Youssef Ahab Abdal Dayam. Etanami Abdumalik Adam. Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Alua Tamishi Daniel Akand, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Mushal Alam, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Muhammad Ali, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Austin Anthony Arab, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. James Thomas Brenton, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Brandon Joseph Burns, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Nicole Hampson Burrell, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Reese Yatil Butler, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Shauna Christine Campbell, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Nicole Danielle Clements, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Jonathan Alexander Matheson Cox, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Perfect. Shati Ereskan Kolak, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Danielle Savannah Crow, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Brandon Patrick Creamer, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Patrick DeVoe, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Nicholas Mark Mackenzie Doucette, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Anthony Joey Fakir, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Leon Amandi Farron, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Cameron Fillmore, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Jonathan Florian, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Matthew Leon Goodick, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Ian Alexander Saunders Green, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Eric Brody Hernandez, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Hayden Nix Radin, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Alexandra Kail, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Mohammed Hassan Kassem, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Erica Kelly, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Saif Rahan Kahan, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Matthew George Lawen, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Zhishuang Lui, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Aiden Oliver Levy, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Valerie Ann McCarran, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Matthew Stewart Mason, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Fallon Olivia Morrill, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Matthew Moulton, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Nicholas Wayne Noggle, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Jean-Luc Niomoimu, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Alexandra Christina Oliver, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Brendan Robert Charles Richards, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Noah Rowland, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Parker John Router, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Cody William Smith, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Graham Sidney St. John, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Kobe McKeel Shannon, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Edward Andrew Steves, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Allison Monica Stenhouse, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Benjamin David Trites, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Wei Jie Wong, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering.
Congratulations, sir.
David Gregory Thomas Watson, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Jeremy Stewart Watson, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Caleb Wood, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Noreen Yasmin Zaman, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Cizhao Wu, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. En Zhang, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Shihao Zhao, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Conrad Steven Zinnick, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Bachelor of Engineering.
Mr. Chancellor, as an Associate Dean, I'm pleased to be here today to celebrate the accomplishments of candidates who have fulfilled the requirements for degrees within the Faculty of Graduate Studies.
Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Master of Applied Science. Ahmed Abdullah, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Fariba Hussan, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. David Ide Mudia, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Riley Nathan Nader, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Abula Adulaim Adejai, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Shubhajit Roy, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Master of Applied Science. Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Masters of Engineering. Amit Paul Singh, Master of Engineering in Networking. Gubit Kar, Master of Engineering in Interworking. Mehbab Ali, Master of Engineering in Interworking. Gohit Agarwal, Master of Engineering in Interworking. Parneeth Kumar Anathula, Master of Engineering in Interworking. Mansha Anwar, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Zahir Aram, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Sai Krishna Teja Ayagani, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Sai Sinkat Parab Bandaru, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Taranjit Singh Bawa, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Priya Dipbai Bahlarara, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Karthik Chaparavu, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Harman Chada, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Roshini Girish, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Shikhar Chikarta, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Mohammed Haroon, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Manasa Jangmang, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Shruti Jagumbar, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Aksha Kanchela, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Himansh Kumar, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Rohit Lagasetti, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Xavier Satyakapash Mattapudi, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Sai Satendra Maluri, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Imran Ahmed Mohammed Nani, Master of Engineering, Internet Working. Asim Ali Jundar Mohammed, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Nikiben Vijaykumar Patel, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Okay, perfect. Shivani Prajapati, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Shiva Kumar Palila, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Chianet Rekham Kumar, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Isaiah Khawaja Mohammed Riaz, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Nakiran Savanan, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Samit Sigal, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Rahil Pankaj Kumar, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Vishnu Kamishkala Shah, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Rohan Sarif Saik, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Ashika Mary Simon Tayil, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Prashnat Singh, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Rishabh Singh, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Masters of Engineering.
Please join me one more round of applause for all of our graduates today. I would now like to call attention to the families and friends of our graduates. We know that convocation is a very important occasion for you as well, and I'm sure all of us here recognize the important role that your love and your support have played along the way. So we would like to express our gratitude to you for the role that you played. If I can ask the graduates to stand, please. And if I can ask the onstage party to stand as well. Graduates, your family and friends have been applauding you and making some awesome noise all day. throughout the convocation in celebration of your achievement. So it's now your turn to return the applause and make some noise in honor of their support and their love. Thank you. Please be seated. Thank you.
Dr. Barry Kerlich is an assistant professor in the Department of Civil and Resource Engineering and holds the Canada Research Chair in Coastal Water Resources. His research examines how human activities and climate change influence the hydrological processes in Canadian landscapes ranging from the Arctic to the Canadian Maritimes. Since his return to his native Atlantic Canada and his Atlantic Canadian roots, as a faculty member at Dalhousie University, he has received numerous awards, including Early Career Research Award from the Geological Society of America and the International Association of Hydrogeologists. It is with great pleasure and pride that I invite Dr. Barrett Kerlich to address the convocation.
Well, good morning, Chancellor, President, Provost, members of the academic procession, so many family and friends, and of course, the class of 2022. It is a wonderful privilege to have the opportunity to address you and offer you my warmest congratulations, both to the graduates and to the many that helped them along the way. It truly has been a team effort. It's impossible to pass a final exam in engineering until you first learn to read and write. It is the culmination of many years of hard work, as has already been said today, but it's more than just the end. It's the end of a degree, but it's not the end of your career. And as Churchill said in 1942, following an Allied victory, he said, "It is not the end. It is not even the beginning of the end, but it is perhaps the end of the beginning." And so it is with you. This is a victory for you today to graduate with a diploma or a degree. And it is also the end of the beginning. So as you look back at your time at Dalhousie at the beginning, it's also appropriate to look forward to what lies ahead, to what lies beyond the beginning. So if you'll indulge me, I'd like to lay out a few guidelines for you to consider as you navigate some of the choices that you'll have over the coming weeks and months and years. Just 3 points quickly. Number one, don't strive for the praise of others. Rather, strive to serve others. In ways that we don't even fully understand and in ways that we would never like to admit, we often run our life in a way to try to impress others to earn their praise. That's a soul-crushing endeavor. And I want to share two stories with you this morning that illustrate the futility of seeking satisfaction in the praise of others. So just a few days ago, last week, I think, I received an award from a professional organization I'm involved with. I was at the conference. I came home, and my wife must have told my oldest daughter, Lily, who's 5 years old, about it because she came up to me and asked me to see the award. And like so many fathers, I deeply want my children to think I'm clever and impressive. And so I thought, well, this will do it. And I showed her my award. I thought she would look up to me with adoration in her eyes. But instead, she expected far more than just a piece of paper, a certificate in a frame. So she looked up to me with great disappointment. And she said, "Oh, Daddy, maybe if you had worked harder, you would have got a gold medal." Yeah. Yeah. So don't strive for the praise of others. Look for ways to serve them. It'll always disappoint you. My other example happened in 2009. I sat where many of you sit today. I was receiving my Bachelor of Civil Engineering at another university, but in a similar setting. And I just found out a few days ago that I'd won the Lieutenant Governor's Medal for highest GPA in the Faculty of Engineering. I was so excited. I'd worked very hard to do that. Worked a part-time job and studied very hard.
And so I didn't tell my parents because I wanted to surprise them when they got to the ceremony. So after the ceremony, after all the pomp and circumstance, I walked outside and found my parents. And my father, in his decidedly PEI stoic way, said, first place, can't do much better than that. And that's all he said. So once again, I was disappointed when seeking the praise of others. A nobler pursuit, a more rewarding pursuit is to seek to serve others. As the Apostle Paul said in Philippians, do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility count others more significant than yourselves. That's very hard to do. But that's one of the greatest gifts I have as a professor and as an academic mentor, to serve undergraduate students and to serve graduate students. And that can be exhausting at times because there are many demands on your time. But it's also exhilarating. It's energizing to see your present and former students succeed, to grow, to become better people, and to become better engineers. And you all will get to serve as well, because you're entering a profession that's fundamentally a profession of service. From public health to building safety to systems that improve our everyday lives, engineers are all about making the world a better place to live and serving those that they interact with. And if you can derive satisfaction in that service, you will be happy and fulfilled. My second recommendation is to intentionally love your work. This time of year, we hear many speeches about following your passion and doing what you love. But I think it's equally important to emphasize the value of loving what you do. That is to intentionally love your job and work at making it a better place for you and for the people you're working with. I'm incredibly blessed to work in the field of water resources engineering. I love my career. I'm outside a lot. I get to work with small communities. I get to work with larger governments. It's a lot of fun. And sometimes I say, I like my children, but I love groundwater. But I'm just joking. My children are three daughters. They're far more endearing than water flowing through dirt. But I do love what I do, and there's a few ways I've found to actively love my job. One thing that helps is to focus on the team that you're a part of. I think of myself as part of two teams, my department team and then my lab team. And in both cases, in both teams, I have great affection for, great fondness for my colleagues and my students, and great loyalty to them as well, because partly I put a ton of time into them, but also in part because they put a lot of time into me. And intentionally directing your career and making choices in such a way that you can spend more time with quality people who care about you and that you care for is one of the ways you can actively love your job. You can make decisions in your job to make it more enjoyable by being around the right people. Another action that helps me intentionally love what I do is to stop and think about the big picture. I can sometimes be overwhelmed by certain aspects of my job, as you will as well. Not every single tiny minute detail of what I do is enjoyable. As example, I don't particularly love pretentious academic clothing. And as another example, I don't like online teaching. In class, I can tell when no one's laughing, and I'm used to that. But in online, you can never tell. There might be someone laughing, and it's hard to relate. So in tough times like that, I think about the big picture. And for me, I think about the fact that over 2 billion people in the world drink groundwater. And my role as an educator and as a researcher and a mentor in the field of groundwater engineering is a critical role, both locally and globally. And you too must figure out how to contextualize your work in the broader picture in the society that you engage in. Because if you see how your work fits in, you will be much happier and you will learn to love your work. Another way to intentionally love your work is to realize and celebrate the dignity that can only come through work. There's an honor through work that the independently wealthy person who retires early doesn't have the opportunity to earn like you do. A job well done, a good day of work, a good decade of work is worth celebrating, and there's so much dignity and honor in work. So embrace that. But the most important thing I could tell you about intentionally loving what you do is simply to be good at it. And that's so important, it's my third and final point. Number three, hone your engineering skills. Hone your skills. You cannot underestimate the strong relationship between your enjoyment in what you're doing and your proficiency in it. Simply put, we love what we are good at. And thankfully, you can work hard as an engineer to develop skills, to become good at things you didn't used to be good at. We live in a generation where there's a renewed interest in crafts people and craft work. That's why sites like Etsy exist. And engineering is a profession, but it's also a craft where skills are critical. So embrace that. Engineering's math and science, but it's also art, it's also business. And there are many opportunities for you to develop skills and things you didn't used to be good at and thus disliked, but then become good at and thus like. As you look older, you'll think back to many examples. I think of just public speaking. I used to literally run from the room when people would ask me to come to the front, but now I teach for a living, right? So, and I enjoy that most days. So I encourage you to think about that. It's not always love at first sight. So in conclusion, seek to serve others, intentionally love your work, and hone your skills. If you're successful in those three things, you will be successful in your career. And just as importantly, you will find it a rich and rewarding endeavor. I'll close by once again congratulating you all. I wish you all the very, very best.
Thank you very much, Dr. Kerlick, for that beautiful, inspiring message. If there's one superpower our children have, it's to keep us humble and to keep us grounded. And I love the way you summarized that. And I also love your message of humility and service. It really was inspiring. Thank you very much for that. Graduates, let me be the first to acknowledge that as you leave the auditorium today, you will officially become part of Dalhousie's alumni network of over 152,000 people around the world. This is a wonderful asset, and I hope you take advantage of the connection to the broader Dalhousie community. We invite you to get involved. We invite you to stay involved. In recognition of your new status, members of the Alumni Association will be presenting all of you with an alumni pin on the way out of the ceremony today, and we hope you wear it with pride. Congratulations again. Welcome to the Dalhousie alumni family. Graduates and guests, the business of convocation is concluded. After the singing of O Canada, if you are able, you are requested to remain standing as the academic procession leaves the auditorium. I now invite Mary Austin, a Dalhousie voice student from the Fountain School of Performing Arts, in the singing of O Canada. Thank you.
Me dead in my neck, done. gemacht, aber hon madultine. Hey, aber hon madultine, dann gisulte liga luxigo, ulausig amo, hey, aheu.
Hey, hi, 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 hey, hi